you go, $40.
No, man.
Hey, how's it going? My name's Alex, and in this video, I transport a Ford F-350 from Iowa all the way down to Texas, and the Ford is actually right there. It is my Ford. It's back. We got a Ford in the family, finally, the Power Stroke. And this is the Ford that I actually transported already once before. It's the problem child in the trucking business. So let's go do the super quick montage and let me tell you all about it. All right, it's back, the 2020 Ford F-350. And earlier today when the dealership was open, I asked them to leave the keys inside the fuel door. And sure enough, they did, which that is fantastic. So definitely a huge shout out to Billy and Ford in Clear Lake, Iowa. They took good care of the truck, I guess. I mean, it's an enterprise truck, so it didn't cost me anything. But yeah, overall, I thought they handled it pretty well and, you know, as quick as they could, it seems like. But right now, I just want to load it up onto the trailer and pull it all the way down to Texas. So this thing's been parked for a while now. Let's do this quick cold start. I mean, I'm pretty sure it should fire up. Let's see. All right, today we're going to be doing a survey. And the survey is a simple question. It's, have you received $40 from me yet? And I got my binder, I guess. Oh, it's my paperwork binder, but I want to look official like I'm asking a survey. And I got some cash. Well, this is only $40, but I got like some more cash.
I'm doing a quick survey. It's just one question. I was wondering, have you received $40 from me yet?
No.
No? There you go. $40 for you, sir.
What's that for?
Does he answer the question? Okay. Have you received $40 from me yet? No? For you, sir. That's for you. Thank you. $40 from me yet?
Nope.
Nope. For you.
Thank you.
No problem. Have a good one. No. For you.
Oh, appreciate you. Thank you.
No problem, man. Have a good one.
Welcome.
Just for you.
No, no.
No, seriously.
No, no, why?
Just because you answered the question.
I can't take it.
No.
No?
No. Are you sure? Just a coffee, a lunch?
Why is it free money?
That's okay.
No, man.
It's okay. Trust.
Why?
Because you answered the question.
My guts won't let me to take that.
$40?
Yeah.
All right. We'll ask somebody else. Thank you.
Thank you.
Nope.
Wow. That was our first no.
Okay. Have a good one.
All right. Let's get back on the road. Believe it or not, it's actually pretty boring transporting your own truck. So what I ended up doing is I did put all the bed stuff back in, got my window shades in, and I actually already hit the road too. I forgot to record the intro, and so that's why I recorded the intro to, like, in the beginning of this video. I recorded it after I already unloaded it. But not only that, I actually forgot to unrecord unloading it. So seriously, but yeah, that's the problem with transporting your own truck. You know, it's just so boring. But anyways, what I do want to cover is, let's say you have a CP4 that breaks down or you have a problem with your truck. I want to go over what, like, I'll put on the list everything that dealership replaced so you guys can see what to, or know what to expect. All right, so first off, I want to say that this cost me nothing, cost the driver dropping it off nothing. Literally, like I explained in the previous video, I just had to get the driver a hotel, I think for a night or two, and then pay for the rental car to go get the Ram that Enterprise gave me. And this, I'll say that this is one of the benefits of the Enterprise program. You know, trucks are not perfect, trucks suck, believe it or not, and they fall apart. So imagine if this was, imagine if I was so excited about the Ford and I bought this brand new truck for $60,000 or whatever they are, and all of a sudden for 3 months straight that truck broke down. 3 months straight or something like that. Maybe it might be more. So yeah, honestly, I'm very pleased with the Enterprise. But yeah, look right here, all these zeros right here at the bottom. Look, no labor, no nothing, okay? But look how much, let's go to the second page first. And so right here, 40,000 or 40,001 found truck was no high pressure fuel, low pressure test fine, found metal in fuel filter, per 310-00B, removed all fuel and low pressure fuel pump, cleaned out tank, replaced pump, gasket filler assembly, then flushed system for 5 minutes, replaced all injectors, fuel rails, sensors, lines to high pressure pump, replaced high pressure pump, used IDS and uploaded new injector IQ numbers, bleed air out of fuel system and got truck running, found minor coolant leak on hose, replaced O-ring and retopped off coolant. Let run half an hour, test drove, no codes return. So yeah, that is, okay, here's the totals, by the way. That is 0000. So that is a lot. Sounds like a lot of work, basically. Sounds like that bill would have been a lot. Who knows if that would have been covered under warranty? I have no idea. But long story short is, like it says right here, so pump assembly, fuel injection, look at all this stuff. Kit, fuel injection, manifold assembly, fuel supply, bolt, clamp, bolt, sender and pump, gasket, cooler, filter, element, pipe, fuel, gasket. So, but anyways, like it says, a bunch of stuff was done to it, and I'm happy this wasn't my bill to pay for. And like I said, I did just drive it, you know what I mean? And honestly, it seems to be running fine. Now, about these Fords, by the way, yeah, I'm watching several videos, and it looks like there's a couple issues that are being discovered. The rear axle seems like it has some issues, but even more importantly, the transmission seems like it has some problems. And what I want to say is, I have had two Fords now, or three Fords now, I think. The white one, I think, and then the dark gray one, and then this silver one. And all three Fords, around 50,000 miles, started to shift a little funny. And like 40,000, 50,000, like once you start getting 60, 70, you really start to notice it. And I'm seeing on YouTube that somebody just had to replace the transmission. It seems like the 10 speed is not very robust. So I definitely would not recommend buying a Ford right now while they're figuring their stuff out. Like, not only do you have the CP4 problems, not only do you have, you know, maybe some transmission issues, it's like, yeah, I would say just wait. Don't get a 2020 or newer Ford F350 with the 10 speed, because it doesn't seem great. So I'm glad to have it. I'm glad I have it back. I'm glad I got to drive it. It's back and I'm excited, you know, because the MPG is good. But I am even more glad this thing isn't mine. You know what I mean? I know in a little bit I get to turn it in and get a new one. So that's always exciting. But I want to ask you guys, what do you want to see me cover on this Ford? Right now that I have the Ford back in the family, because the driver is driving a Ram. I got the mega long Ram. Obviously, I still have that. But what do you guys want to see about this Ford? You know, I think I did a pretty thorough walk around in my previous videos about it, both at 50,000 miles and at 75,000 miles. But and my thoughts for the most part haven't changed. But besides that, like, transmission issue. And it's not that when I was going through that issue on my first Ford, I didn't know if it was just me or that's normal. You know what I mean? But now that I do see that they have more issues, that's like, stay away. But the question remains, what do you guys want to see me cover on this Ford that now that I'm driving it? And that's going to do it. Comment below and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.